welcome back for the second section by Dr. M. Rupesh sir. For that, now I request Shweta to give a brief bio sketch of Dr. Rupesh sir. So, our next speaker is Dr. M. Rupesh Kumar sir. Currently, sir is working as a professor and head Department of Pharmacology in Sri Adi Chanchanagiri College of Pharmacy, Bangalore. Sir obtained his bachelor degree from Dr. MGR University, Master's in Pharmacology from Jadavpur University and PhD degree from Jadavpur University. Sir has about 20 years of experience in teaching and 15 years of experience in research, national and international. Sir has published nearly 95 papers in well-reputed international and national journals with positive and generous attitude. Sir has got 2 patents and published 2 books. Sir was an invited resource person for CME program on HTN and AIDS. Sir has research interest on mechanism of tissue injury induced by drugs, cellular and animal models for assessment of biological effect of xenobiotics and hepatotoxicity studies, molecular and biochemical pharmacology, inflammatory mechanism, eclycemia and endothelial cell permeability. Other than this, sir has approved as postgraduate guide at Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences and approved guide or supervisor in different universities. Sir has served as an examination panel member in Dr. MGR University, Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bangalore. With this brief bio sketch, I would like to pass the screen to Dr. M. Rupesh Kumar, sir, to take over the screen.
Good afternoon. Thank you very much for introducing me, and thanks to Principal Sir of RIPER as well as Dr. Somashekhar Reddy, Head of the Department Pharmacology, for inviting me as a speaker to this AIT sponsored STTP program. So myself, Dr. Rupesh Kumar, right now I'm leading the Pharmacology Department. And the topic given for me, or I have chosen, is biological evaluation of herbal medicines. So here it is a generalized topic. It means if you go for biological evaluation or pharmacological evaluation, there we can come across so many subtopics. Say example, alternatives to animal screening model, or the present scenario in animal screening model, like we can go for zebra fish, alternative animal models, and if you go for how to apply the animal studies, okay. So CPC as well as IAC, it will take a separate one class to explain about this IAC as well as CPC norms, because as a member secretary of IAC of our college, when we call for a meeting, IAC meeting, even the senior staffs, they may face problem how to fill the form B. So again, I have to call and explain them. So it is essential in this stage, in your stage, so to know about what is Form B and how to fill, okay, why it is needed. So all these, some outlines we are going to cover in today's session, that is biological evaluation of herbal medicines. So in my previous session, Dr. Anne Gowda has explained about the isolation parts. Okay, so I think you have gained more knowledge about isolation, and why I want to bring about isolation here once again means because the topic, if you see, you know, it is herbal medicines. So during my period, like say example 1890s, we used to carry about the projects in pharmacology. My guide from Jadavpur University, there by saying my seniors are from advice from my guide, everyone used to do projects in plants, medicinal plants, okay. So during that time, my PhD guide alone is quite different. He has done his PhD in biosis, only in biosis. So he never used the medicinal plants. During that time, his period, the prime minister abortions was more in Calcutta. So he want to know why it happened. So he has taken the venom from scorpion, okay, and he started to collect the placenta from government hospitals. Around 300 biosis he has done, and he has given some new molecule in that field also. So like that, I got interest to divert and to find out the molecular level mechanisms in our pharmacology field. So if you see, you know, my project, I have done the dynamic properties, pharmacodynamic properties of snail. You know snail? Yeah, in rainy season we can form. So in seashore we used to collect and start to break the shell, and I have found the respiratory tract, okay, respiratory tract as well as the venom in the snail, and thousands of snail we used to collect. And being a tissue, immediately you have to keep it in ice bath and start to do the detection, otherwise it will deteriorate. So thousands of snails, if you cut and do the dissections, you will get small amount of tissue. So we have to go for homogenization and separate the active constituents. Like that, if you see, you know, in pharmacology, different research in different level it is going on. But today our topic is biological evolutions of herbal medicine. It is a generalized one. Okay. So what I mean to say, during this pandemic conditions, so we have come across so many things, and I was interacted with so many research people. And even the traditional medicines, again we are coming back to traditional medicines, and everyone is advising us to take daily the decoction, means in boiling water you have to add turmeric powder and pepper, ginger, and if possible some tulsi leaves. Okay, so all it makes us to come again to herbal medicines. Clear? So recently I have received one more project, that is traditionally he is practicing for the treatment of coronavirus. It shows nice effect, the patients are recovering, but scientific evidence is not there for that plant. So they made MOU with our university, and now we started to work on that herbal medicine. So like this, what I mean to say, the young buddies, pharmacology people are there, research scholars are there. So we have that ancient system of medicine. That is nothing but herbal medicines. Clear? So with this brief introduction, let me pass on to my presentation. So here the contents, experimental animals in pharmacology, just because we should know on which experiments, which animal we have to select it. So all the animals is not suitable for all the experiments. And coming to next, maintenance and approval of animals for experimentation. Already I told you how to preserve the animals, because that is very very important parameter during your study. So when you start to carry out your animal studies, suddenly you can come to know the feathers may fall or some infection it may start. So if one animal dies, no, continuously it affects all the other animals, so at last collapse of your research may take place. So maintenance and approval of animals, it is very very important. And alternatives to animal experimentation, already told you. So some in vitro techniques are there, that also we are going to see. And at last, pharmacological activities using experimental animals. So coming to the introduction. So here I told about the medicinal plants. Here the plant kingdom, actually plants, it provides numerous of phytoconstituents. As the Dr. Anne Gowda mentioned, lot of phytoconstituents are present in our nature. Okay, we have to identify and we can move it into next step. So previously what we will do, we'll make extract like methanol extract or aqueous or hydroalcoholic, and we will administer to the animals, and from there we can find out some significant pharmacological activities. Now based on that old ideas and knowledge, what I mean to say here, why can't you go for the newer formulations? Newer formulation means we can jump our field from crude extract to green synthesis. Because right now I have started to my MPharm students as well as PhD students. So we are extracting, and the same extract can be converted to nanoparticles. So we can call it as a green synthesis. Okay, so why Sutics department? I am not blaming anyone. Sutics people can do microspheres, nanoparticles and different formulations. So being we are rich in this nature, medicinal plants, we can correlate now. So I have started to prepare the nanoparticles of root extract. For that it shows a nice effect actually. So why we are going for nanoparticle means just to increase or to enhance the bioavailability. Because when we start to present the work, the research work based on medicinal plants, always people start ask questions. What is the bioavailability? Can you justify it may produce 100% results? So that time we are facing problem, and again the suggestions from the evaluators, they said to go for isolation. Find out the exact molecule, what is the structure, and what is the mechanism, expected mechanism based on that structure. So like that, so many controversies are there in our research field. So for that purpose, we know already some, say example, some alkaloids, flavonoids, rutin, saponins, all are present in the nature. So why can't we convert that into nanoparticles and enhance the bioavailability? So by increasing the bioavailability, still better therapy we can achieve now. So like this, by keeping this, the older knowledge, we are upgrading. We people, pharmacology people, we are upgrading. So now here, to identify the new natural products in the medicinal plants, and if possible, go for next step, like the nanoparticle formulations or even microspheres. Okay, now the newer techniques have started, that is crystal, liquid crystals. So nanoparticle, one side it is going on, the other side liquid crystals is going on. Some US projects are approaching India for this liquid crystals. You can make by using plant extracts or crude extracts, you can convert into liquid crystals and find out the activity. Still, it will increase the bioavailability when compared to nanoparticle. So like this, so many newer techniques are there. So with this introduction, what it happens means it leads or it stimulates our mind to deep again and again in the depth of the pharmacology subjects. Now next, objectives of today's presentation. Actually, the purpose of biological screening and evaluation of plant extracts is mainly to find out the pharmacological activity which is essential for humankind purpose. Okay, it should serve humankind, not only just for our project purpose. So the main objectives of this is two. Number one is pharmacological approaches that utilize different animal models. So zebrafish, I heard about this college that already they have started for undergraduate level zebrafish studies, because zebrafish around 83 to 85% it's similar, the genes are similar to human beings. So like this we can say animal models. Okay, it is not an animal, but we can find some alternative models to bring it better way. After that we have to approach clinically. By seeing the preclinical results, we can go for clinical approach also. This is the main objectives. And next, pharmacological models, if you see, they are in vivo model, in situ and in vitro models are there. Again, I am telling you, don't think we heard this title. Because when we were discussing in scientific talk, some people got still doubt what is in vivo, what is the difference between in vivo and in situ. Clear? So in vivo model is actually it utilizes non-anesthetized animals. So briefly, if you want to say we can administer the drug to the animals. So it may be in any route, intravenous or intraoral or even cerebral, intracerebral, intrathecal, subcutaneous, whatever it may be. All it comes under in vivo model, whereas in situ model is it utilizes anesthetized animals. Test compounds are directly injected into the target tissues, either tissue or organ. So here I said now virology studies are going on. So we can select specifically, or say example diabetes mellitus. Okay, usually what we will do, we will induce diabetes by giving STZ, and after that with the standard drug and our drug test compound, we will find out the nature of the glucose. So why can't you go for directly injecting the formulated drug formulated means extract as soon as possible, you can go for nanoparticle. That you can directly inject into the specific target, means in the tissue, and take the tissue, homogenize it, and find out the nature of the receptor, what it happens. In this way, molecular level mechanisms we can predict in our research. Clear? So this is how in situ models also there. Then in vitro models, we know already it is done outside the animal. Means not inside the body or inside the animal. Externally we can carry out some test. So that belongs to in vitro models. So why in vitro model is essential means, see now CPC, when you are applying for the proposal to get permission to carry out animal studies, the people will object. On what basis you are saying my X plant is having this activity? Because from literature, you can say it may have some alkaloids, or traditionally they have said it may have liver tonic actions, or it is used for the treatment of some viral diseases. But the director, without any proof, how can you prove, or how can you say why we have to give this many number of animals? So in this case, this in vitro, it plays an important role. So you have to carry out some in vitro test by using some solvents, and it is nothing but outside the animals. So if it shows some significant activity, then you can proceed for in vivo studies. So these are some general introductions. Next, the use of animals in our field, particularly pharmacology. There are so many uses of animals. If we ask, no, people may say it is used to carry out experimental pharmacology. So experimental pharmacology means what? Under that there are so many subdivisions. Right, from say example, animals are used as predictive models of humans for research into diseases such as cancer and AIDS. So predictive, we can predict the models by using animals. Number two, animals are used as a predictive models again for humans for testing the chemicals alone, not only the disease. Chemicals alone, we can say example, carcinogens, cancers. Okay. Then the third one is animals are used as spare parts in person's research. The example is given here, aortic wall from a pig. Okay. So this aortic wall we can replace even in humans by taking from animals. Then animals are used as bioreactors or factories, such as the production of insulin or monoclonal antibodies. So here monoclonal antibodies means again the research starts now in corona pandemic situation. People start to ask so many questions. What is monoclonal antibodies? Because you might have heard about this monoclonal antibodies. Those who infected with the corona, so they developed some antibodies in their body. So from there they are taking, from the plasma they took the antibodies. From there, is there any possibilities to develop the vaccine? Like that also research is going on. So these are some important uses. Again here some more points about the animal usages in pharmacology. It is given here. Time is very less, so I'll skip this slide. Next, preclinical trial. So this is very important in our things. So again I'm telling you the participants, all these slides we know, don't think like that, because I want to correlate. Okay. So what is the importance of medicinal plant and what is the preclinical studies, and that really preclinical studies where we have to apply. Like this I want to correlate. Okay. So what is preclinical trial? I think you know very well. You know or not? This is experimental pharmacology. So preclinical trial is nothing but by using animals we can carry out the test. That is preclinical studies or trial. And next, several steps in preclinical trial. How to conclude your project? So it starts from number one, that is identify a drug target. So again I am telling you, when you are focusing for projects, simply don't go for selection of plant first. Okay. So find out this problem first. Okay. So if you know the problem, no, then we can get the root how to solve it. So now presently we have pandemic situation. So that is the major problem. So next to that, if you go for diabetes, Indian population, maximum people are suffered by diabetes. So what is the root cause for diabetes? So this we can call it as target identification. Okay, identify the target. Then next, develop a bioassay. Say example, bioassay already some models are there. Okay. Now in thousands of newborn babies, presently I am telling you, One baby used to get the congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Okay, so now we know very well, because when we observed both the sex, male and female, some males, they may have acted like female. If you see female, no, appearance of mustache, beard, so all it indicates the hormonal imbalance. Sometimes what will happen in female or male, when they starts to grow, the puberty stage may not be there. Even they may not grow according to the age proceeds. So they're mentally retarded. So all we can call it as congenital adrenal hyperplasia. So there, the method so far available method is very less. So how to create the method to solve this problem? So when you come across this stage, you have to see this adrenal stimulation, means the adrenal, the type hormonal stimulation, how it acts, how it produces in our body. So presently some drugs are available like metoprolol. If you see the drugs, no, if you give, it will induce the cholesterol pathway. If you there in the cholesterol pathway, if you see, no, there are so many enzymes in between to enhance the pathways, like 7-hydroxy or 11-hydroxy carboxylase, like that so many pathways are there. So you select any one target, you no need to undergo whole cholesterol metabolism pathways. So in between any one step you can take and you can fix, that is your target. So how to enhance that step? Okay, so like this you can develop the bioassay or develop the novel model for your research. Okay, this is the second step in your research. Now also so many people are there. Okay, I come to know research scholars. So already if you designed, no problem. Or if you are going to design, fix the solve, means fix the problem first. Then you go for finding the novel methods by developing. Clear? Then number three, screen the drug in the assay. Now only you are coming to the drug. So either you can take plant material or you can take some available isolated compounds even. See, always I will not say don't go for only plant products. Plant are there, but even see rutin is there, isolated compound, rutin, then what to say, andropropholite. So we all know very well, andropropholite is paniculata. That plant is given for the treatment of the corona now. In Tamil Nadu state I observed, they have made it as powder and it is bitter in taste. Okay, so we have to boil it and drink. Like that officially they are supplying. So now look at that compound, it is available in Sigma. So bring that compound and start to screen it for the pharmacological activity. So this is the third step. Then fourth one is establish effective and toxic doses. So here CPC as well as IAEC plays an important role. When you come to IAEC, people are saying IAEC, in our period we used to carry out the toxicity studies by Wilcox and Litchfield method. So there around 100 animals we have to use. 10 animals in each group, we have to fix the smaller dose to higher dose. So at the 50% where the mortality rate, we have to fix it. Now it has been changed totally by the CPC and IAEC. So they have introduced OECD guidelines. So there are 4 or 5 OECD guidelines to minimize the usage of animals. So there you have to fix the dose of your plant or your new drug. And at last, if you get high significant values, then you can go and file it for new drug. Yeah, so these are some steps you should know basically before starting your research. And next, under the screening of drugs, why we have to carry out the screening? Particularly now we are coming to the topic. Why we have to go for screening of plants or isolated compounds, whatever it may be. Because the first point you see here, to get the pharmacological activity, thoroughly we have to get the pharmacological activity. So if anyone asks you to reproduce it, so you should be able to reproduce the activity again and again. So you cannot say that time the species varies or the plant is collected from Anantapur, it may have different property. The same plant if we collect from Tirupati, it may have different property. Like that you should not claim. Okay, reproducibility, it should be there. For that only we are going for screening. So screening means there are two types of screenings. It means it comes to plant or the drug, or it comes to animals also. So for all the animal studies, first you should go for screening of animals. Okay, so select, suppose IAAC has given you permission to use 50 animals or 48 animals for your study, anti-diabetic study. So what to do? So you select the animals and subject it initially. So give STZ and find it that either the animal is suitable, healthy wise it is suitable for the study or not. Because when you are inducing, no, some animals will die there only. Some animals will tolerate more and it will not show any glucose increased level also. Clear? Or simple things I will come to explain you, analgesic activity. So everyone, background of pharmacology people, you know very well, analgesic activity, anti-subject method is there. So when you are placing the animal over the heart plate, the cutoff period is 15 seconds. But some animals know it will sit for longer time. It will never show any response, that is a jump response or licking response. So that time what will happen, the paw, it get injured. So this animal is rejected from the study. So all these, like this selection is called a screening. Okay. So why we are going for screening means to get thorough pharmacological activity for new or undefined chemical substances. So sometimes in plant, nobody has reported which compound is responsible for this antiviral activity. So you are going to prove it to the society. For this, screening is essential. Next, to investigate the functions of endogenous mediators. So this first point itself, lot of meaning is there. Okay, you are going to identify the unknown compound. Number two is that you are going to identify which mediator is responsible in the body. Suppose inflammation. Inflammation is there, no? You know very well that the arachidonic acid metabolism pathway, it undergoes two, cyclooxygenase and the lipooxygenase. So it will produce some mediators. That is called the mediators of inflammation. So in pathophysiology we have studied. Able to remember? Prostaglandins, interleukins. Because now the researchers are focusing particularly on interferon alone. Or we are focusing particularly on interleukins alone. Instead of writing the title, project title, evaluation of anti-inflammatory activity of so and so. Instead of this, you can modify the title. Okay, elucidating the mechanism of action or elucidating the molecular pathway of interleukins in inflammatory reactions. Able to get my point? Understand or not? So this is number two. To investigate the functions of some mediators which are responsible for that illness or during the pathologic conditions. Then the third one is to measure or define the toxicity of unwanted actions during your research. So three important points you have should keep in mind before going for your research. That is called the screening. Okay. So next slide. Types of screening I told you. So when you start your project again, you should ask questions within yourself. That is number one you see here. Is there any biological activity? Suppose I took some X product. Okay. It might be there or not. Definitely everyone will have that question. Biological activity is there or not. Number two, is the substance is active? Because in that X product, n number of substances may be there or something, only one compound will be there. It may be active or it may be inhibiting nature. That also we have to ask that. So answer for this, from literature survey we can get it. So number three, you see, in what ways the compound acts. Because if you see our host, n number of mechanisms are there. If you take CNS, GABAergic, so many receptors are there. So what receptor is responsible? How it got affected by our new drug? So like this, we should ask questions before a screening. So while asking these questions, we have three models of screening. Okay. So one is a simple screening methods. Number two is a blind screening methods. And the third one is a programmed screening methods. So let us see one by one what is simple screening methods. So here, simple screening from the name itself, simple, okay. Just see here, to find the substance are active in a single way. So it should not act on any other mechanisms. So when you are giving treatment or when you are... Okay, sorry. So see here, simple. Yeah, simple screening. Now, here the main motto of this simple screening is to find the substance which is active in only any one metabolic pathways, in any one way. Suppose when you are giving or when you are starting to administer the drug in the animals, it should not affect the kidney. So hepatoprotective activity you are doing, so it should act on livers alone. Understand? So during that time, say nanoparticle you are administered, and definitely the metabolism is enhanced. Definitely it will act on liver. So your study is hepatoprotective activity. So by increasing the metabolism, by increasing the elimination as well, it should not affect the kidney. Okay, so this type of questions and answers, it comes under simple screening methods. Clear? So this is inexpensive and less time consuming. Select only suitable method, only select, you should not carry out all antioxidant studies. So suitable method, one or two you can select and finish your projects. Best example here, it is hypoglycemic testing for this simple screening. Ability of a compound to diminish the blood glucose levels, we have to check it. And coming to next, it is blind screening. So blindly, from the name itself you can see blind, without knowing anything, we are following. Okay, so say example, it is a new chemical entity or isolated naturals, and here you don't have any literature of the new product. Okay, so some plant you can identify on the street or in forest, and if you observe, no, name is there, but the literature, it is not there. So you cannot say which pharmacological activity is there in that particular plant. So in this condition, we are going for one type of screening, that is called a blind screening. So without any prior pharmacological history, you want to create new history, you can go for this blind screening. And next, it is programmed screening, programmed. So now here it provides information what compounds are active in what ways. So exact molecular mechanisms, if you want to elicitate any molecular mechanism, you can go for this programmed screening models. So just meaning I said, okay, less than time. And next, this is the route map of preclinical studies. So preclinical studies you have initiated, then immediately you have to go first for this in vitro, because to minimize the number of animals. So when you go for in vitro, you can characterize all this. Receptor characterization, you can go receptor binding assay, enzyme inhibition, secondary messenger analysis, all are comes under in vitro. When you are coming for in vivo studies, then pharmacological studies and toxicological studies, these two you have to come across when you go for in vivo studies. Okay, then why we have to find this toxicological studies? To produce the safety, and the pharmacological studies is to show the efficacy of the new compounds, because efficacy plus safety, both are essential before releasing the compound for human use. Okay, so without safety, and only it produces efficacy, so you cannot bring it to the clinical trials. What we are discussing is preclinical. So once it passes all these tests, then you can go for next step, that is clinical trial. So this is the roadmap of preclinical studies. And method of screening of it is there. First one, we can go for in vitro. So in vitro, it is carried out by activity assays, screen the activity, bioassays. Here the picture shows inner organ part. So we are isolating the tissues and we are carrying out some experiments. Okay, that is the best example to say in vitro studies. And here the types are given here just for your knowledge purpose. So it is a chemical assay using reagents, cultures, and even immunological assays, some cancer, cell line studies also, it comes under in vitro. Next, biological screening. So biological screening, it means we are using the animal model. Biological is nothing but pharmacological, or by using the host, not human beings, animals. Okay, so when you are doing these experiments, we have to follow some biological indicators, because see body temperature. It affects, say example, antipyretic activity. You know, no, antipyretic activity, we can record the temperature through inserting the probes or thermometer in the anal canal. So some drugs when you are inventing, you see you are carrying the research for diabetes, but you come to know the animal research shivering. So it may be because of decreased temperature. Who knows, your drug may have that X compound to reduce the temperature also. So this biological indicator, body temperature, we have to keep in mind, and blood glucose level also we have to check periodically, irrespective of your studies. So you are going for anti-cancer, during that time also you can check the blood glucose levels. Okay. Then next, behavioral responses. Sometimes animals becomes more aggressive, so that you have to check it. It starts to bite each other and it will kill the other animal also. Sometimes it tries to eat also, because overdose of CNS stimulant, it affects, it produces psych effects in the brain. So that may leads to over aggressive nature of the animal. So that also you have to observe, that is behavioral responses. And coming to serum parameters, you are isolating or you are collecting the blood samples. After that you are going for centrifuge and you will find out the elevations of so many enzymes like SGOT, SGPT, serum creatinine, albumin. Okay, because elevation in SGOT, SGPT shows clearly the illness of the organs. Okay, any organs is damaged inside the animal, it shows elevation in the parameters, serum parameters. Then after the contraction and relaxations. So here why I put this contraction and relaxation, nowadays again the health problem, when we are discussing about the health problem, rheumatoid arthritis is the major health problem. Even in female as well as in male, after the age of 50 or even at the age of 45, present lifestyle, they may have this pain, knee pain, even joint pain. And if you are not taking proper treatment, no, it continues. At one stage, the joints, it becomes stiff and the persons may not act freely. Okay, so during this time, if you go to hospital and when you are subjected to so many tests, this is one test. This contraction and relaxation of your nerves and muscles, they are checking in the big hospitals. So there they will use cell cultures to find out the contraction and relaxation of your nerves. Clear? So this is also one of the parameter, biological indicators. And last, growth inhibition of cells also we are noting. So these are some biological indicators we are using. And next, animal studies. Okay. So animal studies can be carried out whatever it may be under three steps. Clear? So now steps, before going to the steps, just see here. Factors, we have to consider these factors for carrying out animal studies. One is species, so we cannot select all the species. Suppose say I worked in Malaysia, there we cannot get this here, which rats you are using for our animal studies? Albino. I just completed, no? It is albino rats, other name? No, SD is there, Sprague-Dawley is there, then Swiss albino, clear? So in India we are using Swiss albino, whereas in Malaysia they are using SD rats, Sprague-Dawley rats, because this species is not available there and this species is not suitable to that climate. Like that, so it may vary the species. So first important one is species and the age also. Okay, so proper age, it means proper weight you have to check. That and all in the following slides it will come. And the strains and the some disease also we have to consider. Okay, the animal should be free from diseases. Sometimes we have to induce diseases, so this also we have to keep it in mind. And in some cases both the sex we are using for research purposes, but in some case only female alone or male alone we are using. Say in case of infertility, understand, or some hormonal studies, there we have to go for estrus cycle. So while carrying out estrus cycle research, you cannot select male rats. So automatically we have to go for female rats. So the sex is also very important, and environmental conditions also essential. Okay, so you have to maintain the temperature. Okay, suppose for example, if you carry out the project today, morning 9 o'clock, if you start to administer the drug, okay, oral route, by orally. So throughout the period, suppose 7 days the studies is carried out, means every day 9 o'clock you should start to administer the drug. Today 9 o'clock, tomorrow I have some test or some internal is there, some teacher called me, so I am unable to administer the drug by 9, means your research report may vary, because the plasma level we have to maintain exactly, then only we will get the report, expecting report. Clear? So all these parameters are there. By keeping this, there are three steps to carry out animal studies. Number one, step one is the toxicological assessment of chemicals. Of course, this is the first step to carry out toxicity studies. Again, under this, if you go, no, there are acute, subacute, and chronic toxicity studies. There you will come across about OECD guidelines. Now, OECD guidelines 420, 423, 425, like that, different numbers are there. So you can use very less number of animals, even the dose also very less only, like 5, 50, 150, 200, like that, the fixed doses are there. Okay, so this is the first step to carry out the toxicology studies. And number two, it is an evaluation of primary and secondary pharmacological activity. So now I want to add one point here. Free radicals, you know very well, free radicals. Now we all are sitting, we may have different immune system. Everyone may not have same immune system. Someone may have some disease or some infection. So that will be invaded by our own immune system. So whenever the free radicals are dominating in the human body, okay, so it should be scavenged or it should be nullified by our antioxidant systems. So you can correlate this free radical activity to all the diseases. Free radicals are dominated. If it goes in higher concentration, it affects pancreas also. So when you are going for diabetes, you can correlate that diabetes to this scavenging activity. So like this correlating, no, that we can call here as a evaluation of primary and the secondary, because it supports your findings. So directly you cannot say my product is having anti-cancer activity. We need some supportive documents. So for that, you should carry out primary and secondary pharmacological studies. Number two, animal models of induced disease and the injury. Then step three, pharmacodynamic studies and the kinetic studies we have to carry out. ADME, you know very well, absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. So that we have to carry out, and tissue, organ, fluid concentration estimations. Sometimes you can go for isolation of all organs, vital organs in the body, in the animal. Then you can go for histopathological studies to find out what is the nature of the cells. That is given next. And last one is, already I told you about serum biochemical parameters like SGOT, SGPT to find out the elevation levels. Okay. Next. Basic overview of toxicology. Presently we are here only. Okay. So self-medication. You are taking more. So pandemic means vitamin C we are taking in higher amount. Vitamin C capsules, chewables, without knowing the exact dose. Okay. And if you got some throat infection, it may be because of dust also. But people are saying it is corona. So immediately we will go for taking of ivermectin or vitamin C, some supplements. So automatically, like put on, you see the picture, it shows clearly. So basic overview, in vitro toxicology we should know, as well as in vivo toxicology also we have to carry out. And next, animal testings. Now we are coming towards animals. So animal testing, the detailed animal testings are required before human studies are being conducted. It means before going to clinical trials, you should carry out preclinical studies. That's what it is saying, animal studies. Next, types of animal test, it is given here. Okay, so so many tests it is given, just see here. Pharmacological effects like hepatic, liver, renal functions. Okay, nowadays people are carrying diabetic studies. Not only diabetic studies, complications of diabetic studies is carrying now. At the same time, we can prove my product is having anti-diabetic activity, and it may cure the complication like nephropathy, neuropathy, retinopathy. All these are the complications of diabetes, correct? Diabetes is characterized by 5 pathies. So among that, the major one is retinopathy, damage of retina, neuropathy, and one more, nephropathy. So we can include either these three, any one, under your project to support more and more. So here animal studies can be done along with this additional parameters, hepatic, renal functions, and blood and urine tests to find out the kidney nature, and at last all your findings can be supported by this histopathological examination of particular organs. Kidney means you can take histopathology of kidney, okay? And liver means again you can go. Pancreas you can go. Clear? Some adverse effects also we can find out by carrying out this animal studies. Okay, these are normal points. Moving to next slide. It comes from eyes. So this parameter is also very very important. Why I am saying means these things. So participants, don't think 70 to 80 ml is there in mice. No, it is not like that. It is C per kg. Okay, so you know very well what is the normal weight of this mice. It is around 25 to 30 grams. Then you calculate how much ml of blood it might be there in the mice. So these things, suppose blood parameters, I told serum biochemical parameters. If you want to estimate SGOT, SGPT, so-and-so, you need at least 5 ml of blood. So if you select mice for your studies, you won't get 5 ml of the blood in the animal. So you should not select mice for that type of studies. This is the things, and some disease which is affected to this mice I have given here, and body weight for this mice, this is the food, the combination of this food we are giving. Next, rat. Okay, so name is given and scientific name and respiration rate as well as pulse rate, blood pressure. Sometimes in Bangalore I observed some colleges, they are doing pulmonary aorta. There specifically they selected only that tissue and they are carrying the project. So there you should know what is the normal BP of the rat. So you can correlate the BP to particular tissues also, how it happens. Because if you see BP, no, again it is correlated to aldosterone system, renin-angiotensin system. So that also you can correlate here. Okay. So you should know, everyone should know the parameters of animals before selecting the studies. Next is guinea pig. We know very well guinea pigs, what is the normal weight, and the blood ml also it is given here. Next, uses of mice. So previously some parameters it is there, slides will be available here, you can keep that slides, parameter slides. Now experimental uses of these three animals, particularly mice, toxicity studies can be carried out by using mice, you know very well, then assay of insulin and screening of some chemotherapeutical and teratogenic agents also we can carry out by mice, even cancer and genetic research. So here you have come across the word, MPharm students can come across transgenic animals. Okay, transgenic animals, and we used to say knockout animals also. So knockout means in gene level they have altered it. So they will just replace one pair and introduce it, and the mating will be done, and the offsprings may be like the mutant species. Okay, so that type of animal we can call it as knockout animals. The cost of a single animal around it is 48 to 50,000 in INR, Indian rupees. Clear? So it is too high. But the cancer studies we can perform, or even now this coronavirus also we can use this knockout animals, particularly mice. Okay. These are some experimental uses. And coming to rat, evaluation of psychopharmacological agents. So here the lab I inquired, neuropharmacology is going on, like that they told me. So you can correlate that psycho, okay, to carry out the neuropharmacological studies, rat is used, and some toxicity studies also we can carry out, but particularly anti-ulcer and hepatoprotective activities, and anti-ulcer means fundus and the strip colon, all we can separately isolate and perform or start to read. Okay, so for these rats are used, still we have so many uses, but some important use I have given here. Then coming to guinea pig, what is the guinea pig use means, particularly anti-asthmatic. Now coronavirus is there, again I am telling you, if you are going for antiviral studies, you can simultaneously perform this experiment also, because bronchodilator, you know very well, breathing problem. In corona patients what they are saying, oxygen level is very less, patient is unable to breathe properly, so we are supplying oxygen. So during that time, what will happen? The contraction process of bronchial tree, it will be high when compared to relaxations. So relaxation and contraction has to occur at equal interval. If it occurs, no, now I am talking normally. So in this, instead of this, if contraction is increased and relaxation is decreased, means definitely we have this breathing problem. So it is nothing but asthma, we used to say. So these studies can be carried out by using this guinea pig. So this is the supportive. No madam, we are not going to induce the virus here. Guinea pig. Mutant. Yes, no, it is not infected, because supportive documents only we are doing. If it is infected, no, by this time we got medicine for this corona. Because like pharmacology, it is rodents only, we are using
as animals, similar,
but we are using the property alone. Say example, here bronchodilator, I said only bronchial tree we are using in case of this animal, but in coronavirus only bronchial tree is not there. Even alveoli sac, it got accumulation of fluid, so we cannot bring that alveoli sac under guinea pig. So for that we can go for some other animal. Like this, step by step we have to bring and conclude it, then at last we will go for clinical trials. So preclinical, we cannot say it is 100% it will be useful to human beings. Again, it has to subject it to humans, and it has to undergo so many trials. Okay, there are so many phases. After that only the product is released into
which is experimental animal
for coronavirus. That's what I told you, madam. Specific, it's not here. And the people are trying with the no, directly knockout animals they are trying now. Still research is going on, that we have to change the how the virus is mutant. Every time, second wave, third wave, it is changing by itself. So when you are trying to do research for second wave, automatically third wave it came. But still we are in second wave only, question mark. Still we don't know. Because exactly alone, rat alone is not the model to find out for coronavirus. Okay, Namita? Yeah. So next slide, can I move? Yes. Next is rabbit. So this is also one of the common laboratory animal we are using. Some parameters is given with the normal water say blood volume and average weight. Okay. And what are the uses or what type of studies, as madam asked? These are some studies we can carry out by using this animal alone. So this rabbit cannot be used for all the studies. Okay, so main pyrogen testing, anti-diabetic study, bioassay of insulin. Now in my college, one of my faculty, he has invented one chip. Because the corona test, you know, they are inserting strip one stick in the nose, and people are getting fear by seeing that only. So instead of that, what he has done, he prepared one chip. If you speak, no, with the saliva only, if you dip it, the color will change. Like that, his idea was there. He was doing that. For this, he has used this rabbit. So he administered the drug and he collected the blood sample. And again, he has carried out so many evaluation parameters in the blood. Okay. So that is the newer one. So you cannot say only this property is there for rabbit. Who knows? You can create one novel model. New model you can for any type of disease. Okay, so research, we cannot say this is the fixed one or it is the defined one. Within this defined only we have to care. It is research. Why we are saying research? Research. So you can swim. By selecting rat, you can, one of you can go for invention of new drug molecule for the coronavirus. Clear? So these are some important points about rabbit. And next is a hamster. Hamster, this is also one of we can use, particularly virology, as madam asked, virology, immunology and virology, particular we can go here, this select by selecting hamsters. Okay, so in India, I think in Pune, only in Pune we have virology center with the full fledged they are working. And even I approached for my new products, we are in the queue. So that's it, after so many, means at least it will take minimum 1 year to enter my products. by the time fourth wave, sixth wave, anything may come. Clear? This is how, where we are. We are lacuna in this field only. So the animal used for this immuno and virology is this hamster. Particularly we can use this. And next, this is after crossing all the smaller animals. So you are giving exactly, completely you know. With high confidence you are saying, my product or my new formulation is having this property. That time you can go for higher animals. Okay, monkey. Even in our period, when I start to read the MPharm, that time we have used dog also for our experimental purpose. But now dog is banned. So during that time we have to search dog. Okay. Give money to some people and bring it, tie the legs, everything, tie the mouth and carotid bleeding. We have to do whole pharmacology lab is excusing of blood. This and all there that time. Now it is banned. So monkey means you can go. But after passing preliminary studies. Clear? So what type of activity you can do? Infertility, virology, immunology, immunosuppressant and some mutations. These are some clear uses of this monkey. Coming to dog, already I told you, but now we are not using this dog. So I skip this slide. And pig. So so this pig respiration rate, everything is given. Coming to the uses. It is used to find some respiratory medicaments, even GIT disease also. Clear? So this is how. Next is choosing of animal model. Already I told you this is very important steps. On what basis you are going to choose the animals? It depends on your protocol only. So first let us see. Laboratory animals are used as models as humans. A model is nothing but a representative of the target. So your model is the representative. For the human diseases or human systems. Okay, understand what I mean to say, the first point. So second one is animals in normal conditions are used, or sometimes a diseased condition is induced in the animals. So say example, analgesic activity means normal animals you can use. Whereas diabetes means how to carry out diabetes studies or anti-cancer studies. So we have to induce. So we can call it as infected or induced, disease induced animal. Diabetic animal we are using, or cancer animals we are using. We will inject the cancer cells in the abdomen. So wait for 15 to 20 days, it will swell nicely. So cancers are developed in the abdomen, intraperitoneal fluid. There you can suck. So you can see the pus cells. If you inject the same pus to other animal, again it will develop. So this we can point out here. Sometimes a diseased condition is also required to carry out animal studies. Then the third point, each animal species encompasses number means more. This is, indicates larger numbers, larger number of strains. For example, there are more than 100 varieties of rats that are used for experimentations. So hence appropriate species and strain should be chosen for proposed experiments. This is how we have to select the animals for our studies. Next, examples are given here how to choose. First one, anti-emetic property of drugs cannot be tested on rodents because they cannot act as a model. The reason you know very well, it doesn't have vomiting center. So we cannot carry out this anti-emetic property of rodents. Number two, to observe pupillary changes, rabbit animal is an appropriate model. So if you select rat, no, you cannot carry out to measure the pupillary changes. So rabbit we are using here. The third one is an experimental drug that is called Alloxan, produces diabetes mellitus in a number of species but not in guinea pigs. So guinea pigs we cannot use for anti-diabetic studies. Like that the madam asked, no question, I am remembering same only. So even guinea pig we cannot use for diabetes. Like that coronavirus we cannot use all the animals. I told you that hamster and even I think pig, that is suitable to find out the virological studies. So we can select that animal. Next, fourth one is sweating cannot be studied on dogs because they lack of sweat glands. Like this, so many examples we can keep. Coming to next, CPC, already I told you, CPC is the important point. So what is the motto or objectives of this CPC? So in so many STTP programs already I have attended, there they asked in the quiz, what is CPC, abbreviations of CPC. even if you are in MCOM, no, in Viva they will ask you what is CPC. So the abbreviation for CPC is given here, Committee for the Purpose of Control and Supervision of Experiments on Animals. So from the name itself it says control and supervision of experiments. It means we can minimize, the committee is responsible to minimize the usage of animals. So that is the main objective of CPC. And I am going fast because I know you already swimmed in isolation. I saw your faces and everyone, some of them, you said. So let me finish fast. And IAEC, Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. So here it is designed in within college only. So chairperson will be there, member secretary, and members from different discipline will be there, and some two or three persons are outside from the college, like social welfare and the scientists from other discipline from outside of the college. Like that we will constitute some team members, that is called the Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. And whenever you want to carry out your animal studies, you should submit Form B, FORM, Form B. In that Form B, title of your projects, which animal you have chosen, justification for that proper animal, okay, and how long period you will carry out, and who is the principal investigator, and who is the co-PA. So here, people used to get doubt on this, particularly PA and co-PA. See, during paper presentations and all, corresponding author is different case. But when you are coming here, Form B, your supervisor is the principal investigator. So people, what they will do, oh, no, I am the student, I am doing research scholar, I am doing PhD. So all this work belongs to me, I will be the principal investigator, means it is no, in case of Form B. In case of Form B, your teacher or your supervisor is the principal investigator. So like this, we have to submit and we have to carry out, we have to follow certain parameters and that IAEC. Next, composition of IAEC. They may have question also in a second semester. Students, you might have received these questions from the IAEC. So these are the persons present in the Institutional Ethical Committee members. So five members are there. Five members, this is within the institute, and B, these people are outside the institute. So every time this main nominee, CPC nominee, he might be from other colleges, he is responsible for whole team. So he will raise so many questions. If he permits, then you can carry out animal studies. So definitely you will ask, if you quoted for 20 animals, why 20 animals are required? You should justify properly. So there you have to go literature review. Clear? So your literature review, according to literature review, I need 20 animals for this study. Like this confidently if you say, then this nominee will approve your projects. Clear? So like this, so many points are there to discuss. Because of time, I am just passing this. And the goal of CPC and physical facilities of animal house, all it is there. Okay, this I'll skip. Or shall I explain this? It already started. Equal to set. Yes, now here, this is important parameter we have to observe in animal studies. R roles means this R indicates so many, replacement, reduction, refinement, rehabilitations. So here, this refinement, we are in this stage only now. Previously, replacement. Suppose instead of a rat is not cooperating, or rat is insufficiency, you are not getting rat properly, now you can go for other animal. Like that replacement was there. And the reduction, because of CPC, after introducing CPC and IAC, we are reducing the animal. And refinement means when you start to dissect, or when you start to open the abdomen area, so the animal should be properly anesthetized. So pain and other surgical parameters you should keep in mind, and animals should not suffer at all. Okay, so this is refinement of animal studies. And rehabilitation means, during our period, we will never bother about the animals. After finishing our project, no, just we will keep it. It will die after 2 or 3 days. But nowadays it's not like that. Say example, wound healing activity you are carrying. So you are removing the feather and you made incisions. Okay, wound is created. So after your projects, you come to know your drug may heal the wound fastly. So what you will do after that to that animal? So you should take care of the animal. You should give some proper ointments to recover that wound. And you should run its life properly. So you can use the animal for other studies after a washout period. Or you can leave the animal as such. Let it grow and end its life. But you should not kill the animal. So this is a rehabilitation they have introduced recently. Rehabilitation. Previously, we have 3 hours to follow in the experimental area. But now they have said the 4th R is also essential. Okay, next, toxicity studies. Already I told you acute, subacute, and the chronic is there. So what is acute? I have given subacute is also there. Sometimes acute toxicity, you know meaning for acute, it is very less time. Okay, less time you have to carry out. And subacute as well as chronic is for the lengthier period. Say example, when you are coming the complications of diabetes mellitus, you should maintain the diabetic stage for the period of 6 months to develop nephropathy, to develop retinopathy. So this and all we can call it as chronic toxicity studies. Okay, under anti-inflammatory also we have so many models. I think you know, like carcinoma induced, okay, and cotton pellet granuloma. So here carcinoma becomes subacute and the cotton pellet, we have to open the area and the cotton pellet is sterilized properly, you weigh it properly and note down, the same cotton pellet you have to keep inside and put the sutures. So after 7 days, once again you have to open and take the weight, because these pellets, no, it will accumulate the fluids. Okay, so try it and take the weight. So by comparing the weight before and after, you can say. So all this comes under the chronic toxicity study. Like this, every method we have. Acute and the subacute and the chronic. Now next, some tests of OECD guidelines I told you already. 420, 423 and 425. Citing study and main study, acute oral toxicity studies. Can carry out by using this number 423 alone, and the up and down procedures will be there. So here you don't know the fixed dose properly. Okay, so it may be 50 or it may be 200 also. So up and downs will be there. So you say example literature already you have selected one plant. Yeah, madam has done one pharmacological activity already. So from her article you come to know the dose fixed is 200 mg per kg. And 400 mg per kg, like that madam has carried out already one study. So you are also referring same plant, but the activities differ. So in this case, you no need to move on these studies. Because literature says 200 mg, 400 mg is safe. I have carried out. So by keeping that literature point, you can escape this OECD guidelines. But if you come to know that the plant is entirely new, nobody has carried out pharmacological studies. In that case, you can go for this OECD guidelines, toxicity studies. Okay, next. Some examples of pharmacological activities, it is given. These are some names only. Following slides, it will explain briefly. So here I have taken anti-diabetic activity, how to carry out. Say these are the methods, like chemically induced, STZ alloxan is there, but nowadays we are not using alloxan because it damages the vital organs in higher rate. Okay, so we are going for this STZ alone, streptozocin alone. And if you see the articles, no, someone is used 50 mg per kg, some researchers are using 55 mg per kg, even 60 mg per kg also they are using STZ. It depends on the study. Suppose you want to make some new novelty method, means you can increase the dose. 70 also you can go. But at the same time you can go and find the damage of the organs by increasing the STZ dose, how it affects the vital organs. Clear? This is also one novel method to improve anti-diabetes. Number 2, insulin antibodies induced diabetes, virus induced, surgically induced diabetes, genetic models and other diabetes. Like this, so many methods, in vivo models are available for anti-diabetic studies. Then how to induce diabetes, it is given here. Suppose those who completed M.Com or you come to know how to prepare, means you have to prepare freshly buffer solutions. Okay, in that buffer, this STZ should dissolve. So before this, what you have to do? You have to keep animals ready, marking should be done, average weight, that body weight you should know. According to this body weight, how many ml we have to inject, all calculations you have to do before commencing your projects. Okay, so all parameters, stable work you should do, then you go for buffer preparations, then add STZ in either 50 or 60 or 55. Okay, immediately you start to inject that STZ in the abdomen area of the rats. Okay, then start to observe the animals for 7 days. So we will consider the day of injection is zero. So initially, if you check the blood glucose level, it is normal only. The next day, means today if you inject, no, day 1, tomorrow is day 1. From day 1, 7th day, 14th day, 21 day. Like this 7 days, we have to give gap just to develop the blood glucose level. Okay, and by damaging the beta cells. So this is how we are proceeding the experiments. And next, dividing the groups, it depends on our study. Suppose already I told you 200 mg per kg, 400 mg per kg, so there are two groups. So that two groups can be included. Suppose you have only one dose, means one group we can include. So always group 1 serves as a normal control, it is treated with vehicle alone. Okay, so vehicle, what is vehicle alone? You know vehicle. Say example, you have plant extract, it should be dissolved in some suitable solvent. Okay, so what is that solvent? The solvent we could not say actually. It is a suspending agent. For example, PIN-80, PIN-20, carboxymethyl cellulose. Understand? So in this, any one of this, we can dissolve it. Means we can suspend it. Then administer. So sometimes in group 1, no drugs at all. So if you selected CMC for your studies as a suspending, CMC alone you can give in group 1. That is called the normal control. Number 2 is it serves as a diabetic control. So here animals are induced diabetes, but it is not receiving any drug at all. Not even the test drug or the standard drug. And group 3, treatment with the plant extract. So it is depends upon your protocol. It may be 3 doses or it may be 1 dose or more than that also. Then number 4, treatment with the standard drug. It may be metformin or fenformin. In case of liver toxicity, silymarin is the standard drug. Okay, like this standard drugs for all the protocols are available. So like this we will divide the groups and administer above mentioned drugs to all the animals once daily for 21 consecutive days. So here the pharmacology people, we should remember this 21 days are there. 21 days exactly same time you have to administer the drug to get the products, to get the results exactly. So don't change the time. Again, I am telling you. Okay, exact same time you try to maintain, then you can achieve something. You can give some new findings in your research. So 21 days we are administering. After that, through tail vein puncture, we can collect the blood and check it for glucose level. Next, at the end of the experiment, the blood sample is withdrawn from all the experimental animals and the cardiac puncture we can do. So if you are well experienced, no, you can measure where we can put the puncture. So exactly at the 5th ribs. So animals are there to anesthetized, okay. So it will be in the supine position. Keep your 2 fingers and just find the 5th ribs. Exactly 5th rib. And there you put the needle and directly it will go. Okay, it will go and puncture the arteries. There we will take the blood samples. Instead of this, if you change your needle, no, it will go either right atrium or left atrium. It will puncture the heart only. Clear? And what will happen? You may not get sufficient amount of the blood. Because when you are puncturing the heart, the squeezing of blood may not be proper. Slowly it will release. Instead of that, either the superior or inferior vena cava, you place the needle, no? Blood will be collected in higher amount. So like this also we are practicing. Or sometimes what will happen, if the students are, we people are not trained properly, what we will do, we are not going for carotid bleeding. Just we will open here, okay? Open here and you can see the diaphragm, okay? So with the help of forceps, just locate the diaphragm make the diaphragm the sac. Above the diaphragm, heart is there, no? You can find the artery, superior and inner, inferior vena cava. Place the scissor and just cut it. So all the blood, it will spew and come and stay in the diaphragm. So syringe, you have to place the syringe, not needle, syringe alone, and suck the blood. So you will get a full amount of blood for your studies. This is also we are practicing. But according to ethics, it's not allowed. Is that clear? In cardiac puncture is like locating the ribs and we are collecting the blood. Next, in vivo models for analgesic activity. So analgesic activity, you know very well, there are three ways: physical method, chemical method, and the thermal method. So physical method means, example is tail flick method. This one, physical. So over the tail you are applying the flick. Physically, you are inducing the pain and the recording the releasing of pain or pain subsidiary actions. So heart rate, it is example for thermal rate, and these are the chemical tests. So physically, chemically, thermally. There are three ways how to carry out analgesic activity, and these are examples for anti-inflammatory activity. Already I told you carcinogen. It is carcinogen is actually acute, whereas a proton oil induced ear edema subacute. Then granuloma air pouch technique is a chronic anti-inflammatory activity. And these are some examples for anti-diarrheal activity. So castor oil induced diarrhea, propulsive motility, lactose induced, then oral motility. So in vivo models for anti-ulcer activity. So this is also interesting. MCOM projects can be carried out by this. So pyloric ligation induced gastric ulcer. Pyloric ligation means in duodenum. Duodenum and the starting point of the intestine. Both the sides you have to put the notch. Okay. Then cut it. Then take the stomach and put it in normal saline. Okay. So start after this. Take the stomach once again, put over the wash glass petri dish, start to cut the stomach in the upper curvature. So it will open like lotus leaf. Okay. So open it, just locate the lesions. It appears nicely, so nicely red color spots will be there. Then focus it on the powerful microscope. Scales will be there. Okay, so you can measure the red spot with the readings. Then that we can make mean value. Compare with control, standard and treatment. Like this also you can carry out anti-ulcer studies. Some scores also available. So substitute that values in the formula, you can get the anti-ulcer activity. So next, in vivo models for anti-cancer activity. So there is carcinogen induced models, viral infection models, transplantation models, genetically engineered. So all these are examples for in vivo. And the chemical carcinogen model, the TMPI induced mouse skin papillomas. So many things are there under anti-cancer. We cannot think it is easy. Okay, it is also like ocean, we can swim. So many methods are there. It takes so many times, and even CPC also, they will ask so many questions when you go for cancer. From where you got cancer cells, how you have transferred. Either you took animal from your institute to the cancer institute. So in what way you have transported the animals? Where is the better? So like this, so many parameters we have to follow to carry out this anti-cancer studies. Then coming to last, it is thank you. Shows finish it fast. Hungry, all are feeling hungry. That's why last slide is anti-ulcer activity. So with this I can conclude my presentation. Once again I want to say thanks to the organizing committee, okay, as well as the principal and the management of PRIPER for giving an opportunity to deliver about the careful medicine evaluations. Thank you one and all. So once again, if possible, no, you ask Somshekhar sir, we can go for separate like webinar, online webinar, to discuss about the specifically like IAEC or CPC, or as madam said, some biological studies. Like this specific, we can, pharmacology people, or those who are involved in pharmacological studies, we can conduct, no problem. This is like generalized topic. So that's why outline only I gave. So specific deeper we can do it, no problem. So contact me in English if you want. We are there to help you. Okay. Thank you.